Hi everyone, today in this video let us discuss side effects of calcium channel blockers in easy way. Calcium channel blockers are commonly known as CCBs. We have three categories of calcium channel blockers. The first one is a verapamil, second one is diltiazem, and third group of drugs are belonging to dihydropyridine category, including the drugs like nifedipine, amlodipine, isradipine, nicardipine, felodipine. In this way, we have so many types of dihydropyridines. All these drugs are classified as calcium channel blockers with a common target, L-type calcium channels. CCBs are going to block L-type calcium channels so that calcium cannot enter through these channels into the membrane. That's why sometimes these drugs are also considered as calcium channel antagonists. But actually, they are not acting on the receptors. They're physiologically blocking the calcium channels. These L-type calcium channels are widely distributed. Few of these calcium channels are present on the heart, and few of the calcium channels are present on the vascular smooth muscle and other smooth muscles. So all these drugs are not similar in their pharmacological actions. Few of the drugs are acting on vascular smooth muscle, and few of the drugs are acting on cardiac muscle specifically. Here in the verapamil, we can denote the letter V, and V is not for the vascular smooth muscle. That means verapamil is not acting on the vascular smooth muscle. Instead, it is acting on cardiac muscle. So this drug blocks the L-type calcium channels present on the heart. On the other hand, nifedipine acts on the L-type calcium channels present on vascular smooth muscle, where it produces vasodilatation. And in the diltiazem, we can find the letter D, which can be remembered as dual action. So diltiazem can block the L-type calcium channels expressed on both heart as well as vascular smooth muscle. Even these drugs are acting on L-type calcium channels, but their location of action is different. Verapamil is acting on the heart. Nifedipine and other dihydropyridines are acting on vascular smooth muscle. And diltiazem can act on both heart as well as vascular smooth muscle. Because of small difference in their location, they produce different side effects. But all the side effects of calcium channel blockers can be easily remembered. So in this video, we are going to discuss how easily we can remember the side effects of calcium channel blockers with a simple mnemonic. So now let us see the side effects of calcium channel blockers. L-type calcium channels are present on the heart, where they are responsible for contraction of the heart. And these ion channels are also expressed on vascular smooth muscle, responsible for vasoconstriction. Now, verapamil is selective for the heart. It can block the L-type calcium channels on the heart, resulting in the decreased rate of contraction leading to bradycardia. On the other hand, nifedipine and other dihydropyridines can act on the vascular smooth muscle, resulting in vasodilatation. This vasodilatation leads to tachycardia, but it is a reflex action. Here we can simply see that both verapamil and nifedipine are calcium channel blockers, but verapamil produce bradycardia, whereas nifedipine produce tachycardia. The tachycardia produced by dihydropyridines is an indirect action. The vasodilatation produced by these drugs results in the decreased blood pressure. And when the blood pressure is going to be reduced, it results in the decreased perfusion pressure. This results in the activation of baroreceptor reflex, which stimulates the CNS to release the catecholamines. These catecholamines can act on the heart, resulting in the increased rate of contraction, leading to reflex tachycardia. In this way, dihydropyridines produce reflex tachycardia due to their indirect action, whereas verapamil produce bradycardia because of its direct action on the heart. This simple difference between the side effects of verapamil and nifedipine, other side effects can be easily remembered with a simple mnemonic. We can remember these side effects as B2H. Every letter indicates one side effects of these calcium channel blockers. So here B indicates bradycardia, C is the constipation, D is the dizziness, E is the edema, F is the flushing, G is the gingival hyperplasia, and H is the hypotension. In this way, the side effects of CCBs can be remembered with the letters B2H. B bradycardia, C constipation, D dizziness, E edema, F flushing, G gingival hyperplasia, and H hypotension. Most of these side effects are associated with hypotensive actions of calcium channel blockers. Now let us go one by one and let us discuss which type of CCBs produce these side effects. The first one is a bradycardia. All we have discussed that verapamil produce bradycardia because this drug directly acts on the heart. Similarly, diltiazem can act both on the heart as well as vascular smooth muscle. Since these drugs act on the heart and block the L-type calcium channels, both verapamil and diltiazem can produce bradycardia as one of the important side effects. On the other hand, nifedipine, amlodipine and other dihydropyridines can produce reflux tachycardia. Second one is a constipation. This constipation is mainly observed with the drug verapamil. Verapamil can block the L-type calcium channels present on the colon, so this drug can reduce the gastrointestinal motility. Therefore, verapamil produces constipation as one of the important side effects. So this constipation is more pronounced with verapamil and less observed with dihydropyridines as well as diltiazem. But other calcium channel blockers can produce abdominal pain as another side effect. Third one is a dizziness. All the CCBs can produce hypotension. The reduction of blood pressure may reduce the blood flow to the central nervous system, which results in the dizziness, lightheadedness, even fainting can be observed. So central side effects like dizziness and lightheadedness is commonly observed with all the CCBs which produce the hypotension. That's why these drugs can produce some drowsiness and sleepiness in the patients. And these drugs should be carefully combined with other vasodilators in order to avoid significant hypotension. Fourth one is the edema. Particularly dihydropyridines directly act on the vascular smooth muscle, so they can produce direct vasodilatation. Because of direct vasodilatation, the capillary permeability is going to be increased, which results in the accumulation of fluids leading to peripheral edema. So dihydropyridines can produce some ankle swelling and lower limb edema because of their direct action on vascular smooth muscle. Verapamil does not produce significant edema just like dihydropyridines because this drug is not directly acting on the vascular smooth muscle. On the other hand, diltiazem can act on vascular smooth muscle, so this drug can also increase the ankle swelling and peripheral edema. Fifth one is the flushing. Again, this side effect is observed with all the CCBs which produce vasodilatation and hypotension. These drugs particularly produce cutaneous vasodilatation, which results in the increased blood flow leading to facial redness and redness of the skin. This may also result in the decreased pooling of blood at the skeletal muscle, resulting in some fatigue. So flushing and fatigue are the two important side effects produced by all the CCBs. Sixth one is the gingival hyperplasia. Again, CCBs, particularly dihydropyridines and diltiazem, can produce gingival hyperplasia. These drugs can reduce the synthesis of aldosterone in the adrenal cortex because calcium is required in the synthesis of aldosterone. CCBs can block the synthesis of aldosterone, which is calcium dependent. And when these aldosterone levels are reduced, it can produce some negative feedback mechanism, resulting in the increased production of ACTH from the anterior pituitary. When the ACTH levels are increased, it results in the increased synthesis of testosterone. So this testosterone may result in the proliferation of the gums, resulting in gingival hyperplasia. Particularly, this side effect is observed with chronic use of calcium channel blockers. With the verapamil, after 1 year of treatment, proliferation of gums can be observed. Seventh one is the hypotension. This is a common side effect of all these drugs because these drugs are acting like antihypertensives. So all these drugs can produce hypotension, but they act in different way. Verapamil can act on the heart, thereby can reduce the rate of contraction as well as force of contraction. And when both rate as well as force of contraction are reduced, it results in the decreased cardiac output. So this results in decreased pumping pressure leading to hypotension. So verapamil is producing the hypotension by acting on the heart. It is not directly acting on the vascular smooth muscle. But the dihydropyridines like nifedipine can directly act on the vascular smooth muscle. Thereby, they can produce direct vasodilatation, again resulting in hypotension. So even they act in different way, but the final effect is the hypotension produced by calcium channel blockers. And sometimes they produce orthostatic hypotension, where the blood pressure is reduced by changing the posture. So patients should be given precautions such that calcium channel blockers may induce orthostatic hypotension, and it can also produce some drowsiness and dizziness, which is particularly observed within first few weeks of the treatment. So these are the various side effects of calcium channel blockers, which can be remembered with simple mnemonic B2H. B is the bradycardia, but dihydropyridines produce reflex tachycardia. C is the constipation, which is mainly observed with the verapamil. D is the dizziness, commonly observed with all the CCBs. E is the edema. They can produce some ankle swelling, particularly observed with dihydropyridines. F is the flushing, redness of the face and skin. Even they can produce fatigue as another important side effect. And G is the gingival hyperplasia, again observed with all the CCBs. And H is the hypotension, commonly observed with calcium channel blockers. So that's all about the side effects of CCBs, which can be easily remembered. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.